if you want your viewers to have a better experience watching your thesis, what you want to do is to encode your thesis. This is the FCUX test encoding guide based on Slipher's method. When you want to record a video of your test and upload to YouTube, normally you would either use a screen recorder capturing your emulator window, such as OBS, or record your AVI with a compression factor, such as this. This often yields a bad result down to 30 FPS with bad graphics. There is quality loss. The file size can also possibly be drastically large. Encoding, however, gives you 60 FPS high definition footages. First of all, we have to download FFmpeg from ffmpeg.org. FFmpeg is a complete cross-platform solution to record, cover, and stream audio and video. You can refer to the installation guides below, choosing your system. After you download and extract it, you have to go to the bin folder of FFmpeg. Go to the copy the path. Now go to the search bar, type environment variables. Go to the path and press edit. At the end, type a semicolon and paste the path you just copied and press OK. But I have it already pasted, so I just press cancel. What this will do is FFmpeg will do stuff if you use it in command prompt when you summon FFmpeg. Now FFmpeg is all set up. Let's move to dumping DAVI. That includes video pixel by pixel and audio in original quality. In FCUX, play a movie or open task editor. To record AVI, go to File, AVI, Record AVI. But before that, you don't want the hard elements to appear in your video, such as this frame count input. Uncheck enable hard recording if you have it enabled. And then save config file. Now go to the start of your movie by pressing this button or Shift plus R. Record AVI. Select. Name the file. And select full frames uncompressed. Now play the movie, and it is currently recording. Some people use turbo, but you are not advised to use turbo, as it causes audio problems. Please just sit through when it is playing. After the movie has finished playing and you decided the cut point, right here, stop AVI recording. Now you can find your AVI file here. The dimensions are only 256 by 240. And when you expand the player, it looks blurry. And 3 minutes of video is already 2 gigabytes. We have to encode it. Depending on the length of your movie, you might have the file name, part 2, part 3, and so on. And this will be the case most of the time. No worries. Open command prompt. CD the directory where you just save your AVI in. Type FFmpeg. Dash I for input, quotes, colon cat, semicolon, your AVI file, separated by the OR character, the one above the backward slash, close quotes. Dash C semicolon V for video codec, FFV1 for lossless quality, dash C semicolon A for audio codec, copy so that the audio is exactly copied, and the output file name in MKV format. When it is done, a new lossless video from start to finish is created. Beforehand, you have to know the dimensions of the DNA screen. You can check it here. By default, it is going from the 8th line to the 231st line, only 234 pixels high. The top and the bottom 8 pixels are gone. If you do it like this, see the difference here? This is called overscan. There's an option to disable this by setting this from 0 to 229. I would recommend you doing this as 224 has aug factors. So change this, save config file. To upscale, we want integer multiples of 256 by 240. We multiply both sides by 3 and we get 760 by 720. And 720p already looks pretty good. You may do up to 8k and it just has to be an integer multiple. Okay, so type FFmpeg input. Your file name, just put that, or AVI if you skip the first part. Video codec H.264 for compared codec. Audio codec copy. Dash S for size. Now the size of your choice in width times height. Dash SWS underscore flags neighbor. To specify the scaling algorithm when resizing. Finally, the output file name in MKV format. After another 10 hours, you have your first encoder test. And you have officially joined the encode game. If you have any problems, you may refer to the information below. I also wrote a batch file that makes encoding as convenient as one drag. I want to thank Slither for their encode, but truly, they raised my awareness of making my test movies having a much better quality. This video is using their method. They have a document of encoding guide also down below, and I hope the testing community grows.